system would help any person to come out of operational task and then work on the business strategic or I would say that innovative activities. And for from that perspective, I would say that artificial intelligence is actually ruling the world now, and that is must. And if as you mentioned that Facebook, Google, you pick up anything. And even if you have visited any hotel, yesterday I was in Hyatt, and there they had all my information. And at the same time, not only that information, they were also knowing that what all areas or places did I go, and what all food did I have, and at the same time, what things did I order. They actually tried to provide all those things in advance to me. So that is actually each and everything what I did was captured there, and they just went by the pattern or the kind of stay I had with them or experience with them. They were ready with all these aspects without even giving them call again. So that is the, I would say, beauty of any intelligence or artificial intelligence or computer system is. And that is what we are actually trying to replicate in HR. And HR is also one area wherein I would say that these kind of things can do miracle, and then they can actually take care of many of the mundane tasks and repetitive tasks. And through the system itself, system can identify that what all the preferences of this, I would say, that employee is, and what kind of questions he has asked in last few years and so on. And basis that he could be ready with those kind of answers for each and everybody in the form of FAQ knowledge transfer or so on. So I would say the artificial intelligence is needed. In HR, it is actually adding value. And I had one example, actually, I have my one of my example yesterday. I was actually showing to one of my customer. So although I'm in HR, I'm also interacting with a lot of customers. I am showing them that how intelligence or artificial intelligence can actually rule the world, and how can they help HR to contribute in the transformation journey. And if I get a chance in the end, I will definitely go there and show you that. I have a very small example. So I'll show you that. So Dhananjay, it depends on Dhananjay when would he allow me to show, because I need to access my account. But anyway, so from my perspective, artificial intelligence is the key, and there are pros and cons. It would remain there for each and everything. And obviously, I do agree with Dwarakanath ji, some kind of jobs loss would be there. But at the same time, if I take example of general, one of the Germany-based automobile company, they claim that when they started their operation in India earlier, they actually put most of the resources on manufacturing unit. But later, this time when the artificial intelligence was introduced, they hired 15,000 people, and out of 15,000 people, they put 14,000 on the coding, technical and various activities, and 1,000 on operational activity. So that means they are able to use those 14,000 on other areas, and those 14,000 are the key resources of organization. Earlier, they were only operational guy. So that means we are instilling a lot of confidence on them, and also skilling them with the better technology and utilizing them for better activity rather than mundane activity. So I think, yeah, we'll come, yeah. So that is one area I would say that, which is very important in terms of adopting or having this artificial intelligence in any area or any field.
Thank you, Neeraj. So I'll request the panelists to restrict their opening thoughts to about 3 to 4 minutes each. Which is closer to their heart about artificial intelligence and how it's going to drive success through talent. So may I request N.C. Sharma ji to share his opening thoughts, please. Why not, sir? All yours, please. Sure, about 6-7 minutes, sir. Huh? Yeah.
Okay, thanks. The director of the Institute, Jaipuria Institute, the panelists and the young students. I was a victim of artificial intelligence in 1994. Because when I was working in Jaipur, we had these typewriters, and at the most there was a telefax or there was some machine which was there. So we said, yaar, ye ek nayi problem aa gayi hamare samne. To chalo, hume isse kya matlab hai? But then I got this opportunity to come and get interviewed in Delhi, in Park Royal. So we had a assistant general manager by the name of I'm forgetting his name. So he said that, you know, I'm fine with your experience and everything, but you know, you have to go to the general manager and he'll ask you only one question, and that is, do you know computers? Do you know Windows? And yeah, please usko yes bol dena. I said, yeah, mujhe kuch bhi nahi aata, I don't know anything on Windows. Why will I say yes? Ke yes bol ke ek mahine baad mein teri joining hai, ek mahine baad mein tu seekh liyo. I said, fine. So what I did is I said yes, I was selected, I came to Delhi, and in the meantime I learned a little bit of how to open the computer and all those things. Now the assignment after joining was ki there is a Excel sort of a thing which is there on the computers, so you got to prepare 300 employees total details on what is their name and what is their designation and what is the basic and what is all those things. I did all that, but I'll tell you how I did that, because I didn't know how the Excel works. So I just briefly I'll tell you how I did that is, I selected, okay, you know, when you go to Excel you find all those columns. So I said, yaar sabse lamba naam jo hai char column mein aa raha hai. So I said char column for name, serial number one column, basic one column, HRA one column. And then I took the calculator honestly and basic HRA everything and put it in the totals column, okay. And that is how I prepared the whole sheet. When I got it printed, seven sheets coming this way, then another seven coming, then another seven coming. So I thought, this is a bloody problem here. So usko cut kara, usko align kara, and then I gave it to the general manager. He said, Mr. Sharma, you know shit about computers. You don't know anything. I said, sir, I have done it on computers only, sir. He said, you don't know anything on Windows. I thought, fine. Maybe you can check the totals, they're all right. But how did you do the totaling? I said, by calculator. So, but you know, the message behind is, for the youngsters, wits do prevail over artificial intelligence. That's what I want to tell you. If you have the right wits, you will prevail over artificial intelligence. That's the message what I want to give. Now, one more thing which I want to tell the youngsters is that they have rightly named this as artificial. I'm glad the name given is artificial intelligence. Let's talk about what is intelligence. You see, there is a cognitive intelligence which is acquired by information that you have, the knowledge that you can get, and the skills that are there. This is basically the cognitive intelligence. Then there's another type of intelligence which is the analytical intelligence or the applied intelligence, which is the insight into the subject and the foresight that you can develop out of it. That is your applied or the applied intelligence. Then the third is basically the wisdom and the feelings. The wisdom and the feelings is something which artificial intelligence would not be able to cope up with. It may, but there will still be enough to do in that area. And the fourth is the spiritual intelligence, which is a kind of wisdom, or which is the kind of know-how of anything that exists under the under this cosmos that you acquire. So there is what I want to tell the youngsters is that artificial intelligence is not a threat. It's only going to be a support as long as you have the wits, the feelings, the kind of analysis of situations that is required to do the job in a proper manner. So human being will not be replaced, that's my thinking, although people may say whatever they want to. And this is what I wanted to communicate and conclude, because there are n number of, I've got a restriction of time for 5-6 minutes, so there are n number of panelists who will elaborate on that. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Sharmaji. You really led this with a brilliant point of view, and with over 4 decades of your experience, the way you have summarized and presented in few minutes is really commendable, sir. Grateful thanks to you. And with this, we come to Anil. Briefly, Anil, if you could talk about your opening thoughts about this subject, please. Over to Anil.
Thank you, Dhananjay. First of all, thank you for having me here. With that note, it's very difficult to pick up the energy levels, but I'll try my best. Right now, I think in the previous session there were talk about Davos, so I want to kind of pick it up from there. I think most of us are aware of Professor Klaus Schwab. He's the same guy who is the founder of World Economic Forum. He coined and he kind of published a book called The Fourth Industrial Revolution. First Industrial Revolution was all about going urban, from rural to urban. And that time, we talked about a few invents were, your steam engine, electric bulb, and things like that. Second Industrial Revolution was all about typewriters, those category, telephones, those kind of a thing. Third Industrial Revolution was all about your personal computer. Yeah? The fourth revolution is all about Internet of Things, robotics, 3D printing, yeah? Those kind of a thing. So the point I'm wanting to bring here is technology has evolved, and that has evolved majorly to make all our life easier, keeping the customer, end user, in the back of the mind. That's how we have evolved. Now let's talk about HR. HR has also gone through a few evolution. We talked about welfare officer. It said, any organization which has 500 or more than that number of people on any day of the preceding 12 month need to have one welfare officer. From there, the evolution has been, we talked about HRD, and right now, we have arrived at a stage, we even start talking about organization development, organization effectiveness, chief happiness officer, and plenty. It's evolving, right? What has remained constant is all that revolved around the end user, how the end user would be benefited. Anything which is simpler, better, and cheaper, that is going to stay. That is the crux. Now, moving into artificial intelligence, just before that, I do remember when we started our career during 95, 96, there used to be an office called Time Office, where your attendance would be punched in manually and punched out, timing would be written. Then we have come across and we started biometrics. Yeah, now retina recognition. Two different apps available right now. For example, certain businesses, they would have feet on street. They are not required to come to work on a daily basis, but their attendance is important. They also want to know what are the policy changes that happened, right? And the apps can track whether you were in Atta market and from there how many calls, it will actually give you the map, right? That's what is technology. Second example, we used to do employee morale surveys in the beginning. In the factory setup, normally you will find different corners on the shop floor, and a hard copy would be given to you. You fill up what you feel about your manager, your workplace, the benefits, etc., etc.